running, no gunshots, but they getting low, 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 low.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Welcome back to another video. Today we are on American Truck Sim. We're gonna be hauling a load here. I got hooked up to this already. We got a load of wood shavings. A 36,500 pound load of wood shavings that is going from here in Elko at the Elko at rail export down to Tonopah to the Sunshine Crops. They expect it no sooner than Wednesday at 6:06 and no later then Wednesday at 10:16. Should get $11,172 from it. So we're gonna go ahead, get started up here. ...310-mile journey here. See, and I think we'll drop the tag. Beacon we don't need though. So, this is the new truck. For whatever reason, in the last episode, my OBS decided to, it decided to just record the main screen here in ATS, so I don't know what that was all about. Let me get up to this red light here. So we got a Pete 379 here. It's got a 840 horsepower Caterpillar engine in it, Eaton Fuller 18 speed retarder, lots of chrome, lots of lights. We got the tri-axle. Got the pistol shifter on it. Now let me tell you, this thing can roll. So let's get it lit up here. Oops. So you can see we got some neons here in the got some neons in the air cleaners. And then we got lights on the deck, on the rear bumper, on the headache rack. Get this really turned on here. Let's see, when we pull up here, so we're a total of 80,714, so our truck weighs quite a bit as well. Shut that off. Let's see what else is on this truck. We got the 63-inch sleeper. We got the nice big stacks. Got the beacon. I am going to put a different grill guard on it eventually, but we got the chrome steps with lights in them, chrome tanks, chrome bumper. We got shark teeth on the front that are painted the same color as the truck. We got the metal fender guards. We got the mesh grill, visor, the old school mirrors with forward antennas. That's what I was looking for. Then if we go inside, inside here, we got a red neon light. And we can go back into the sleeper here. Could even drive from back here if I wanted to, really. See, like I said, it's got an 840 horsepower engine in it. This thing can pull just about any load at just about any speed. I had it up to like 90 pulling a 50,000 load of 50,000 pound load of soy, as the game called it, but you know, what would have been like soybeans or something. And unloaded, I can go like 100 easily. You know, I get a lot of speeding tickets if I'm driving this thing empty and I'm in a hurry to go pick up my next load. I do need to put different tires on it. These tires, at first I just kind of thought maybe the way that my camera angle was at one point was, you know, what was wrong with these tires, but no, they just truly do not fit on this truck. So that kind of sucks. But just gotta do a quick switch there, and then I wanna get some new tires or a new grill guard on it. 6,512 loan installment paid. That is good to know. I hired a driver. I don't know if it showed that in the last episode or not, but I did hire a driver. Gave him the old truck, and we are using the new one. Yeah, it's a pretty nice truck. I'm happy with it. I might actually have to remove some chrome though, because I have noticed it does kind of lag my game a little bit, but that, or I just turn my settings down a notch or something like that. But she is a pretty mean truck. Pretty good truck all around. I've put it to pretty good use. I've got 873 miles on it already, so getting broke in. Yeah, I actually, when I picked up this trailer, it was originally like a four-axle dump Mack end dump trailer, but then it had the option to change it, so I had the option between a four-axle, a three-axle, I think a two axle, a log trailer, and this trailer. And I was deciding between the log trailer and this one, and I decided I'd go with this hopper trailer here. Guess it's loaded with wood shavings, so. One thing I really wish that SCS would add is an animated shifter. That'd be pretty cool to see that. You know, every time you shift a gear, that thing moves to the, you know, the correct area for it. That'd be pretty sweet. Now let's just take a look at our route here. So we got a straight shot till we hit that, and then straight shot down to Eli. And we actually don't even go into Tonopah. Tonopah, whatever it is. We're gonna go a little over speed limit here. Just 5 over. Please let there not be a train coming. I had that the other day. I was driving a load and was just hitting 70, and right there was the train tracks, and there was like 4 cars and a semi sitting there. So I had to just literally hold the brakes. I held the brake, the trailer brake, parking brake. Did everything I could to stop this monster. I didn't need to turn my blinker around quite yet, but that guy was moving. Let's get a cruise control enabled right away and just fly through some gears. That's a little bit soon to shift. Chase, in a hurry? Must be. So this really isn't the most highest paying load there is, but I wanted to do something that wasn't too terribly long of a drive. This one seemed about alright with its 300 miles, so. I have to take a quick pause here. I'll be back in just a sec. Alright, and we're back. I'm hoping that it records. Gonna make sure. I'm just gonna kinda go like this. Okay, it is. Good. Thank you. So yeah, once I am done with the recording of this, then I have to work off on off-camera stuff for the Clover Creek video tomorrow. Finish the corn off-camera and just sell grain on-camera. Won the vote last time I looked, so I am just going to finish the corn. Ooh, train. Down. And of course it's gone already. So let's just check here, see what the driver's up to. Company manager, truck manager. Oh wait, no, I want driver. So we have, that's his, he's on duty, it doesn't say if he's, so here's all the specs, the 389, we got the 8x4 chassis, 63 inch sleeper, left-handed steering obviously, 840 horsepower, 1,150 to 1,500 RPMs, Eaton Fuller 18, 237 gallon fuel capacity. Now let's go to driver manager and see what Peter M. is doing. On duty, stop to rest. He is hauling Informatica from Phoenix to Jackpot. Show his log. Okay, so this is his first load. So... Come on, light, turn green. Let's see, I gotta turn left, so I'm in the right lane, okay, good. Fashion. Sportswear. We got just this one more stoplight. thought that car was gonna get us. Trying not to take out any cars if at all possible. I believe it's just a straight shot. We don't have to do any turning until we get to... Yeah, no turning until we get there. Pretty sure we're good on fuel yet for a while. Ah, I keep going past it. Oh yeah, we're good for another like 1100 miles, so. So fuel is not a necessity right now. If I really wanted to top off, I could, but I think we still have like 3/4 of a tank, it looks like. See, is it F4? Yes, it is. Let's just reset all this to default. And then we'll... that way a little bit. I can kind of read it a little better. It's a little better than it was before. We got 87 miles to go. Should not take long at all. This wheel drives me crazy when it does that. But this wheel really wasn't made for American Truck Sim, so. So this does not have an air horn. It just has a horn, and that's it. No air horn. I suppose I didn't even add horns to it. That's probably why. That's another thing I'll need to add to it. Oh, this wheel's driving me crazy. haven't seen a cop yet on this road. Oh, I just about thought I spoke too soon. I thought that was a cop right there. I was just about to say, oh crap, spoke too soon, but it's just a normal car. I'll slow down here since I can't pass right here. Let's go blow them by these guys. Still don't see anybody coming, so we're gonna go past this guy too. I'm sure that was highly illegal what I just did, but and there's the first car. That was a cop. Huh. He didn't do a thing to me. Okay. That one was a cop, but didn't do a thing. I won't complain. Get our tag axle picked up here. Where do you want it? No thank you. That spot is difficult to get into. Let's park it right up here next to this guy that is working on their drills. Probably scared the absolute crap out of him. Both ends trailer don't look too bad. I like how the visor looks like it's painted. Whoops. The wrong button there. So we got 381 XP, 11,172, no damage on the trailer at all, so that's good. Let's go ahead and get this thing out of their way. We'll just pull up right here and that'll do it. So if you enjoyed the video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Make sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Be sure to check out down below in the description for my PC specs, my upload schedule, as well as links to my social medias, mod site, and other cool YouTube channels that are definitely worth taking a look at. Thanks for watching, you guys, and as always, we'll see you tomorrow.